What's going on, guys? This is Cool Shad here, and welcome back to a unexpected video. Today, I am talking about Scrap Mechanic. Now, you guys know that I haven't really been uploading any Scrap Mechanic videos, and I'm kind of sorry for those people that want to see it, But hey, I'm gonna bring back Scrap Mechanic, and I'm gonna make sure I record every video possible equal, as best as possible. I can guarantee you that. But anyways, yeah, I'm with this picture of Heavy eating a sandwich, but it's nothing to do with Team Fortress 2. It's all about Scrap Mechanic. But today is gonna be a very interesting video, I can guarantee you that. So, let's get right to it. Scrap Mechanic. It's been known for its creative mode and how long it's been out for. So, how this game is where you mechanics out there know all about how it is, but people that don't know, you're a mechanic that you start off on a world and you just build whatever creations you want, and whatever you don't fit best, you can create, make it art, like the developers say. But, so, that's kind of how the main of Scrap Mechanic is. Just build what you believe in, you think is cool, or what you think is fun. And Scrap Mechanic has been out for quite a while now, and it's been still trying to go and go. It became from not a lot of structure and nothing much to you can do about almost anything on the game. Do what your imagination tells you to. But it's not about any of that though in today's video. Today is what Scrap Mechanic been mentioning all throughout those years, ever since it came out. And that would be survival. Survival. It's been mentioned many times, but it never came out. Never. Ever since it's been made for Scrapping. Whenever Scrap Mechanic has been made, it never came out. But, thing is though, they've been really updating their channel with all type of stuff, with creative and survival. And they've been putting some interesting stuff on the internet. So, I'll show you guys that in a bit. But survival, yeah, I said it again, it's been mentioned many times and they've been updating, but it's getting better and better. The textures before came a little crappy, but they change it and it looks just perfect. It looks exactly how they would intend it to be. Now, there's gonna be a big video coming up tomorrow. You guys won't miss it, okay? And I will be recording it, so. But tomorrow is gonna be the biggest thing that Scrap Mechanic is ever gonna release. And I'll pop that up right now. Survival trailers coming to 27th on April of 2020. Yeah, this is the biggest news they ever posted through many years they've been out for, which is quite exciting because they never actually got a trailer up for Scrap Mechanic, for survival, because it's just been in so many work in progress, and it's like they can't just post it out right now because it's not even done. And I can tell it's a lot of work to get something so creative like this made. And I'll show you guys more on what survival is gonna look like in a bit. But yeah, so Scrap Mechanic Survival trailer is coming on the 27th on April. That is when it's coming out. So I really hope you guys stay tuned to today's it's for tomorrow's video, and so I'll start showing guys some pictures I uploaded for survival from way back then to today. So make sure you guys don't miss out. All right. So this is from when Scrap Mechanic first, or at least I think, but I can scroll down a little bit and they may mention some stuff about Scrap Mechanic of survival. There's explosives. So they are probably gonna add animals, so let's hope that is gonna be a thing. There's a saw, so you'd think we're gonna probably cut wood. Well, if you thought of that, you're very correct, because that's what's gonna be on. Okay. I don't think that's anything special about survival, just spud gun tile builder. Now, this thing, I have no idea what this is. Some type of like robot that has a screen. I'm not sure, but yeah, they didn't really mention a lot about survival, but like this is somewhat interesting. Although that there is nothing else about this, I don't think. Some more screenshots on that's a warehouse. Ooh. But oh my god, they just have so much stuff. Now you're gonna see some fan art. I'm not showing off fan art, I'm just showing off what they're posting for their what? Testing new steel net block. I don't think that's anything part of the game, I don't think. But yeah, so I'm not gonna dig it no more further down. Let's start going up. So yeah, you're gonna see something like this, some custom player model assets. Yeah, that's not a feature, but for survival it's probably gonna be, because you know it. So like here's a this is your character for right now is just a either male or a female dwarf. So that's kind of your only two option is these two. But yeah. But anyways, so like yeah, pistons, spud guns, etc, etc. Let's get to more interesting information about survival instead of just seeing all this. I'm not gonna edit none of this out because I have problems a little bit for editing, so I hope you guys are okay with this. Anyways, so this last week we made a really nice day slash night cycle. Here is a beautiful sunset from our survival build. Still work in progress, more news coming soon. So yeah, this is quite pretty, to be honest. Got a dwarf on a vehicle, which don't question what that is, but looks like going towards a cow. That's interesting. And there's a, I don't even know what that thing is, some big structure. So November 16, 2018, they have another news update of this, some like the storage box, they say, right here. So it's quite nice. Now, I think that this is like a low level. I'm not 100%, but I'm pretty sure low level of storage container. Because, after all, but in creative mode, you don't, for original scrap mechanic and creative, you don't get no, like, bag inventory. Because, you just have, your inventory is your hotbar, and you get 3 rows, and that's it. But, yeah, this is gonna be a big change for your character, because not only that you might have inventory, but also you can store your items, so that way you don't have to carry so much things. Like, you have to almost do in creative mode. So, they added more stuff to it, so, So this is still looks like the same, but I think it might actually be a power box. So power, I think, for different tiers and some, I would say gas, because this one looks like a gas can, so I think the rest would be too, because they have caps. It's not like oil, which I don't know if they're gonna have oil. I don't think so, but you never know. So, challenge mode, that's nothing special. That's been out for quite a while. So, happy holidays, scrap mechanic, and raft all together. It's not bad, to be honest. So here's another survival update. So you get different tiers of electric motors. Now, those mechanics that are watching this, you know how electric motor looks like. Just default. Quite a plain. How it's always been through its many years on the game. But then you go over, you get more orange, and it has a bit more design to it, which is quite nice. And this one, so it says white stripe, level 3, it has a lot more detail than that one and that one. So, few blue lights. Oh, because that and that. Now, this thing looks quite cool for electric motor, because has that type of design and whatnot. But you know what? I think this thing has a lot of power. Not to mention there's electricity kind of like coming out of it. More blue lights. That is not light. That's electricity puffing out. That's gonna be quite cool when you see that thing running. Wonder how it looks. Probably gonna have animation. Don't judge. I'm not 100%. It might not. It might. You just never know. Just gotta wait until survival comes. Now. Wait, oops. Don't worry about that. So seed. So, original seed. Oh, okay. Level 1 is quite original. Level 2, more orange. I wouldn't say, well, kind of more orange, because you get this and this. I'm saying a lot of this crap. But this kind of changed a bit because this has some dark spots to make it more detailed. So, I got Scram Mechanic opened. I figured why not just turn on the Scram Mechanic music, because it's quite original. Because I'm going to be having a video of this, so why not? White stripes. So, like, the seat belt is going to have white stripes, and this, all that. Quite cool looking. But, I think it could look better. Like, level 4, it really changed its design right here. More blue lights. It looks quite, nice looking. Not too glowy, but, like, has a bit. I wouldn't say just few blue lights. I would say it has a bit more detail, just like the rest. Like, but now I'm looking back at the pictures from a couple of years back, so they probably did a lot more changes to this. But now, level 5, more blue lights, as you can see. Now this looks quite cool looking, because it's the best. You gotta admit, level 5 is best out every other thing, because not only it's, well, now I'm thinking about it, I don't know if the level either matters on the durability of the seat or whatever, or does it have more power to it for whatever reason. Like, I don't see how a seat is gonna have more power. I think it has more durability. But, like, if you look right here, it has, like, a hologram. Like, the speedometer is, like, sticking out. So that's gonna be cool when it comes. And it has way more detail than the level 4 and all the other levels. Quite nice. So, that's, that. Okay, so, we need to push the new dev vlog title Monday next week, but I don't quite know what this thing is. Like, probably a builder? I'm not sure. There's a better view of it, but, you know. So now, I'm not featuring no fan art, because I'm not doing that. I'm just featuring the devlogs from way back for survival to now. So, devlog 17 is... So, this is a tape bot, and it's in this type of factory, so you gotta be careful, because it will shoot tape at you, and you gotta use your spud gun or whatever to attack back at that. So now we got a nice feature of this. So I think this would be like your inventory. More than, but this would be like creative though, for when survival release. So you get backpack, all, tools, block, parts, interactive, and the good old mod parts. And you can see this is your three hot bars right here. One row here, and it stays right here, but it just switches. So you can, you know. But yeah. Now looks a little downgrade for the textures, but I think they're gonna fix that in a little bit. And if you can't tell, if you look closely right here, there's a little mess texturing right here. But I think they are gonna fix all that. Even with this one, you can see one right there. Yeah. So, a new devlog coming next week. So I don't know what this is, cause I'm not, I'm still not sure. Some type of tool. Otherwise, yeah. Now this gets more interesting now. So, devlog 18. Now this is where some cool survival interaction or whatever comes to play, where you have to now battle. You're not alone anymore. So this is a farm bot, but like, this is not this thing right here is not no original farm bot. You can see one right there and one right there. That thing looks like it got damaged on the bottom or something, cause, well, it might move his head down there, I'm not sure. Let's just say it's damaged, but, so these things are not friendly as you think, because if you, because they have a clip that shows these things and the mechanic and interacting with them, they're not too friendly, and you are gonna actually see some animations coming up soon about these things. So, you guys know anything about, like, scary movies, like, for example, Zombie Apocalypse, or something like that? Well, these things are exactly like what a zombie would be, but it's a machine that has hay in it and whatnot and cracked eye. And these things are very, very, very aggressive. And they will chase you down until you either get far away from them, or if you either destroy them or they kill you. So be aware of those things. I've seen what they would do on what the developers put out. So now here's a engine, low level engine. Quite interesting, because you got yourself a tennis ball, a can, a little fan. Hopefully that fan cools the engine enough, because that'd be actually a little bad, because if they have it where that engine kind of runs very long, it would have its, I don't think they get that advanced, so don't worry about that. Kind of made out of wood and metal kind of thing, so that's quite nice. Oh, let's see what that thing does when it comes. So hopefully, can't always rely on things. Good old daily and nighttime cycle. Tossing a glow stick. Oh no. Wait. I can pause it. I never knew I could pause animation picture, these type of things. Okay, that's quite nice. So depends on what you whack on the on any farm bot, that part will have will go flying. Like you see how the head just goes flying right up there. That is quite interesting. Wait, hold on. What is that? It goes right in the face. Got a little tote bot or whatever over there. Yeah. Well, that thing you make for music, whatever, but those things are aggressive too, but not as aggressive. Like, you think. So, they have kind of a view, a range point, so. But it's not as far back as. But if you. Okay, I'm not sure. But appears if you get too close to it, it'll see you and attack you. So. Ooh. So, here's a battle between the mechanic and the. Tape bot. Oh, some crazy creatures. Can I get no. Here, let's try and get a up close tape. It's so hard to get. Yeah, one more time. Okay, that's kind of a closer view. So it is a circle, which that's actually nice because at least it has some type of shape. It's not like how the potato is. Well, it is shaped like a potato, but so appears if you they don't have that good of aim, but just good enough. But I don't think these guys do that much damage. So now we are back with another update, and it shows that we are gonna have a different type of backpack. So let's I want to try and hurry up and get this over with so it's not too long. So backpack, I think you probably store quite a few things in there, so you're more likely having an inventory, so that's nice. So another different type of backpack, I think. If not, no, it's not. I think it's just a preview of the map. This better be a bigger map. Well, not that I'm really wanting a bigger map, I'm just hoping if there would be one, because so before I go to that thing, this doesn't give a really good hint, but except there's a head of a bot. But this is a bot that makes clothes for you, but it's not gonna just give it to you. You gotta actually go and earn it by going out and collecting the resources for it. And I bet you had to interact with somewhere on it to go in its inventory and tell it what you want, what type of clothing you want to make, and it'll make it for you if you give it the resources. So that'll be nice. So more into it is gonna be how are we gonna get the resources? Well, if you look right here, we got a mechanic drilling stone. So we're gonna have drills, which is gonna be quite nice. Now it looks like they did a redo on the wheels, so that's gonna be nice. So, oh my. So don't question what's all on that. I have no idea, but it looks like gas and power. So, you know, like is getting up there. And another point of view of him drilling a bigger rock. So that's gonna be quite nice. But the thing is, though, is there gonna be damage if the stone actually hits your creation? Like, maybe, but maybe not. Just a picture of a mechanic with this creature and that thing just in the air. Whatever type of building that thing is. But now we're coming up to where they're starting to make the ragdoll for either your character is dead, or if you like, or they're having a thing where if you trip on something you actually roll down. I'm not 100%, but I think this is if you die you roll or fall on the ground. Now you can go through the ground a little bit, I think. Oh, and it appears you accelerate too if you are in the steeper, if you're going down steep hills. So it looks like that those things are destroyable by a creation hitting it. So that's gonna be quite nice. Explodes. So now we are now going back to the seat. So survival. You make a seat. At the beginner level, you get the, you make this crappy thing. Yeah, you make this thing. But that's all you have until you upgrade it to those other seats that you've seen down there, which is quite nice actually. You don't have quite a handle, so, but I wonder, is your mechanic gonna have to put his arms, hands in different position because there's not quite a handle, I don't think? Or I think that might be the middle handle for the handle for the steering. I'm not sure, but so you can actually crush them. So that's gonna be nice. You can actually set up a trap, so you can have an entrance and you can just have a open door and you can just try and trick them coming through, but before they go through you can close a door and activate a switch and the walls come closing in and crushes them, which I think that would be a great idea actually. Just have one way entrance that will allow you to go through, but if you're getting chased down and you want these guys gone, you can just have a trap. Just make sure that you don't actually screw yourself over and and not closing the door in time. Oh my god. Some parts just go flying far away. So, if you die, you actually do drop a bag and you have, so you say, your bag will drop with all your items and you have to hurry back to retrieve them before they despawn apparently. So you can lose your items if you don't make it in time, I think. So it's good to hurry back and pick them up when you restart. So I think what they mean by restart as in respawning. So it's gonna be interesting seeing the crash ship in person. So now we are getting into hunger. So you're hungry? So you gotta work on getting your food. So you gotta get something like meat, Maybe get some cheese from the cows and then get a pickle. But I think all you gotta do is collect meat and you just get that or something. I'm not sure. There's no recipes on nothing like this yet. You gotta kinda figure out, I think, yourself, or unless if they provide the resource when they release it, but. Now it looks like you can actually change your steering, and also you can kill the cows with a creation. So apparently you can adjust your steering angle, so I want my wheel to go this far, and I want this other wheel to and when I want to turn to the right, I want to go this far. So that's gonna be nice. Okay, so here's a dress bot again. It's actually an action. So it looks like this is now closed off if it's making clothes. So if it's doing its job, you have to it's gonna have to close that, so I think you're not able to access any of its inventory when it's in doing its job. Okay, we're back to food again, and apparently now you're holding the food and it's just flopping right there, running into this type of cave. That's nice. Now, the stone, wood, and metal. So, scrap stone, scrap wood, and scrap metal. I wouldn't say these are scraps, more like grinded wood and drilled up stone. But I think you're gonna get a refinery though to refine these two metal blocks, so I'm pretty sure. Okay, now we are talking about how we make our food. So we got a cook bot, so doing making some delicious pizzas, putting some cheese on top. Okay, that's nice. Now again, I'm not featuring no fan art that they're posting for the scrap mechanic devs. Okay, this is a kind of big news. So there's actually a farm machine I think you go to, and if you provide a power or something and put items in it, it'll actually make food for you. Now, there's no sound for it, so. But yeah, that's nice. And then we come up to here. Scrap Mechanic Survival. Trailer coming to 27th on April. And that's the last of the update of Scrap Mechanic. So, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and hopefully, you guys are ready for this upcoming tomorrow's video. I'm actually gonna upload two videos, so one about Scrap Mechanic, and also, I'm deciding for now on. Every Monday is a Minecraft Monday. Minecraft Survival Monday. Or however you want to call it. But yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. So, hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Make sure you leave a like and subscribe. And I will give you guys some information on what's gonna happen. Now, follow Scrap the developers on Twitter if you have it. It's Scrap Mechanic. Check them out, follow them, and follow me so you guys can get updated 24/7 on my videos and whatnot. And join my Discord, because if you want to join my Discord, you Well, you will actually. Well, hopefully, I can somehow make a live stream for YouTube. I'm not sure how, but I'll try and get that. But, like, right as Survival comes out, I'll make my. Before I even do anything on Survival, I will record the very beginning. Not even a single setup first. But I am gonna be with my good old couple friends. I'm gonna have a group chat on Steam. So we are gonna be talking while playing the game. I'll let them know I invited them to this group chat because I wanted them to be a part of the video, so you guys get a nice survival experience instead of just hearing me 24/7. So hopefully you guys had fun, and again, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I am trying to get better at doing this. So stay safe, stay sweet, and see you all next time.